Jamie. Hi. You gonna help me drive to school today?
Yeah, I brought a few friends.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Good afternoon. Today is Monday, March 22nd.
Now over to Amanda with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "I can't change the direction of the wind, but I can adjust my sails to always reach my destination," by Jimmy Dean. Lunch for today is a main meal of chicken tenders with whole grain dinner roll and macaroni and cheese, or turkey and cheese on whole grain roll. Lunch for tomorrow is a main meal of meatball sandwich on whole grain roll or PB&J Uncrustable. Now over to a weather report.
Welcome back, CV. My name is Devin, and I'm your weather guy for today. Currently, it is 31 degrees Fahrenheit out. Mostly clear out today. We have a high of 62 degrees and a low of 30 degrees today. We get slightly warmer throughout the day. At around 4 o'clock, it should be around the highest it should be. And there's no chance of precipitation. Anyway, that's all I have for today. So now over to headline news.
Tonight, anger in Germany. Anti-lockdown protesters clashing with police as Europe fights a devastating third wave. ICUs are once again filling up. This doctor says a lack of confidence in vaccines is costing lives. The World Health Organization warned this week there are more COVID deaths in Europe now than in March of last year. Politicians responding with lockdowns. In Paris on Friday, people rushed to leave before new rules kicked in at midnight. Cafes and shops are now closed for a month. Travel restricted to within 6 miles of home. France, Italy, and Poland all imposed fresh lockdowns this week, and the backlash is spreading too, with protests in Belgium, Finland, Austria, and Britain. The rise in infections blamed in part on new, more contagious variants and a slow vaccine rollout, along with the pausing of the AstraZeneca vaccine in some countries.
Once you pause something, you're sort of implicitly saying there's a problem, and then to reintroduce it, I think people will be a little bit nervous.
With the pandemic still raging, Japan is taking no chances. Today, Olympic organizers in Tokyo announced no foreign spectators will be allowed in attendance at the 2020 Summer Games.
It's a necessary move, unfortunately.
The ruling means it's unlikely families and supporters of Olympians will be in the stands to cheer them on.
I think it would be preferable, Kelly, for all of these athletes to have their loved ones and supporters in the stands. But the fact is, this isn't going to have any impact at all on the single most important thing, which is the competition itself.
Kelly joins us now from London. Kelly, those seats won't be empty in the stadiums, though.
No, not at all, Jose. About 4.5 million tickets have been sold to Japanese residents, and they'll be filling a lot of those seats. And we hope to learn more about what that will look like in terms of crowd size and social distancing during the Olympics at some point next month.
Seniors, the Pennsylvania School Counselors Association 2021 scholarship competition is now available to you on Schoology. Participants should be a high school senior planning to pursue a post-secondary education. The deadline for this submission is April 2nd. Now over to Money with Mead.
Mrs. Mead with Money with Mead, and happy Monday. Yes, we only have one Monday left in this marking period, and that is next Monday. So after that, marking period 4, time will fly. So juniors and seniors, you have to be alert. Alert, alert, alert. Seniors, scholarships are flying out now. So you really have to pay attention to your email, your class of 2021 page, and hopefully you're a member of Money with Mead page. But before we go there, juniors, those of you that applied for the Junior Rotary Student of the Month, hopefully you've checked your email on Friday because all of you received an email. Congratulations to the winners. And for those of you that did not get chosen this year, please remember, there's only 6 slots for the Rotary Student of the Month. And we have many, many awards. So don't give up, and next year, just keep writing down everything you do during the summer of volunteering and working and all those kind of things, and I'm sure you will make out very well next year. All right, seniors, the ACT award is due this Friday, and remember that's the one about caring, acquiring, and all those kind of things, is by Kingsway Realty, that is a local one. They choose the winner, so I need to have them in by 3 p.m. on Friday. There's 2 ways you can do it. You can email it to me, make sure you have it all together, or you can send it. You can actually hand it in to Mrs. McDaniel down in guidance office. So there's 2 different ways. It has to be done by 3 p.m. This week, I have 4 new scholarships, so listen up. The CV Mentee Award is, the application is in your email, Schoology of Class of Page, and also on Money with Me. The CV Mentee Award, of course, is given to someone that was in the mentee program. Now, some of you are like, well, we really haven't done much because of COVID. However, some of you have been here since your freshman year, so if you ever were in the mentee program, you can apply for this, and it's for $500. The next one is the CV CCS Community Service Award. If you volunteered quite a bit during your high school career, you should apply for this one. They either give 2 $500 awards or 1 $1,000 award, and CVCCS also chooses the winner for this. The last 2 I want to talk about today are two of the bigger ones that a lot of students tend to go for. The first one is the Upper Leacock Nursing Award. It is $2,000, so if you're going in the nursing field, any type of nursing, it doesn't matter if you're an LPN, RN, whatever you're going to go for, make sure you fill out the Upper Leacock Nursing Award. We also call it the UL Award. So the other one, or the last one for this week, is the Upper Leacock Gold Collar Award. Any of you that have gone to CTC or are going to a 2-year college or going into a certificate program, this is for you. You will receive $2,000 if you are chosen. So if you're going to Thaddeus, you automatically can apply for the Upper Leacock Gold Collar. If you're going into ABC and doing an internship or apprenticeship, you could go for this award. So keep that in mind. Any of you that are seniors, make sure you fill out that application. It's called the Upper Leacock Gold Collar Award. Last but not least, I'm going to say this and you're going to get tired of hearing it. Make sure you check the Class of 2021 page every Monday, your email, or the Money with Me page, because that's where I'm putting all these new scholarships. Make sure when you submit the scholarships, like once again, you either email it to me, Bridget_Mead@conestogavalley.org, or you can hand it in physically to the guidance office. But make sure it's not late. All right, guys, have a great week. I'll see you next week. Bye.
Attention to all seniors. The Conestoga Valley Education Association scholarship is now available. The scholarship is attached and hard copies can be found in the guidance office. This is a $4,000 scholarship, $1,000 per year for the next 4 years. We are looking for students to apply who have excellent grades, leadership, and financial need for college. Please see Mr. Kapp if you have any questions. The scholarship application must be submitted to Mrs. McDaniel at Barbara_McDaniel@ConestogaValley.org by Friday, May 7th, 2021 by 3 p.m. Now over to guest teacher Teen.
Can you guess this teacher, Teen? This teacher teaches in the English department. This teacher has been teaching for 12 years. Their favorite hobbies are cooking, baking, and traveling with their family. This teacher is Miss Katie Fake.
On Thursday, March 25th, the CDHS Marching Band will be holding an open gym rehearsal from 6 to 9 p.m. These are for anyone interested in possibly participating in the marching band this year, regardless of experience. We welcome anyone, including those who have never played an instrument. Thursday's open gym will be for anyone interested in performing as a member of the wind, percussion, or guard sections. On Tuesday, March 30th, the CDHS Marching Band will hold our annual Meet the Band Day. More details will be coming, but we hope you will join us that afternoon and evening to meet everyone in marching band currently and to get more information about the 2021 season. Now over to CV Sports. There's a home track scrimmage against Ephrata at 4.
There's an away boys tennis match against Cedar Crest at 4, dismissal at 2.
There's an away boys lacrosse game against Hershey, dismissal at 2.
There, come on, support the Hawks.
Now over to Sports Island.
Get back in the groove here as Spence leads things off, and the first pitch from Wagner is a ball. Leads the team with 25 hits and also with 19 runs scored, and he drives this one into the gap, and it is out of here. As Spence opens this game with a solo homer over the left center field wall, and Tennessee has a 1-0 lead. Arizona College laces that one in the left field for a base hit. So he's 2 for 2. And the Volunteers have runners aboard at first and second.
Off just a little bit.
Gets the bunt down. Goldstein's gonna go to first. High throw and safe. Goldstein's. Lillard. Chopper on the infield gets through. Pavloni scores. And everybody will hold. The Volunteers have a 2-0 lead. Here with the bases loaded. Line caught. McAllister, double play. Thrown out, got tagged out. You're so accustomed to saying thrown out, and he socks that one into center field. Run scores, it's 3-0, and the Volunteers still have runners at the corners this evening. And ball 4. Socked to center field, and over the head of Gilbert. One run in. Two runs in, two run double for Riley King, and it's 10-4.
No.
Back up the middle, base hit by Harbor. King comes around third, he will score. A 3-run sixth inning for Georgia, and the lead has been cut in half. Got him, Gonzalez goes down swinging.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Anna.
Alongside Shaylee.
And this is CV Today.
Have a majestic Monday.
Try to change you, 'cause they are so afraid of you, but oh.